This is the story of an extraordinary place, a place of magic that calls to you on the wind. This is the story of Aulani. On the leeward coast of Oahu, you will find Aulani.
Aulani is a destination resort that tells the story of the Hawaiian culture. It tells the story through art, architecture, it tells the story through magic.
Hawaii has its own culture, and Disney is probably the best company for storytelling. So when they came to Hawaii, it was really interesting because they looked at Hawaii, at its culture, and Hawaii has its own stories. The Hawaiian culture was actually based on storytelling, mo'olelo, that passed on from generation to generation. And there wasn't any written language here until the missionaries came and developed the Hawaiian language. So when Disney came here, they realized that, they understood that they already had a story to tell. So they really studied it, they took time to invest in the culture here, the cultural leaders, the community, the Walt Disney Imagineers, in particular Joe Rohde, came in and talked to a lot of these people, understood the culture, understood the expectations of a property coming into Hawaii that was going to represent the culture. It's inherent in the name, Aulani. It's messenger of a chief or a higher power, and that's really what we are. We're a portal for the people to understand our culture, and we share that culture, but it's really not ours. We're just telling that story for others who we've learned it from. And I think that really important part of Disney coming in and building this resort based upon that knowledge and took the time and the energy to research it and understand it and build it into the design, the architecture, the music, the room design, environmentally caring for the Aina or the land. And all of that came together by them learning the culture first and then designing the property afterward.
That we did our research and we did our homework, it couldn't be real. It couldn't be about Hawaii without the Hawaiians. And so everywhere you look, you can tell that we have actually partnered with the Hawaiians. All the art that you see on the walls, all the art that you see on the outside of the resort, that art was created by Hawaiians themselves. Now, in stepping back, when we did do our research, we had to ask ourselves essentially, the question, why is Disney here? Why Hawaii and why Disney? And we discovered that Hawaiians are really about three things. They're about ohana, which is family. They're about story, right? The Hawaiians are some of the most fantastic, fabulous storytellers in the entire world. And third, the Hawaiians are about magic. There's this very subtle layer of magic that sort of bleeds into everything that is the culture. Now, Disney is also about family, storytelling, and magic. And so when we started the design of this place, it was pretty easy to say, hey, you know what? We can be Disney and we can help tell the stories of the Hawaiian culture because we kind of are seamlessly, perfectly combined and blended together, and it's a perfect marriage of all of those three things. Aulani actually sits in this perfect site that's surrounded by the mountains and the sea. Now, the Hawaiians designed their regions and their neighborhoods and their communities around what's called an ahupua'a. Now, ahupua'a is a concept where everybody that lives within a region is actually dependent or interdependent with each other. So what that means is, if you're the farmer who has kalo or taro, you trade your taro with a fisherman who fishes from the sea. And all of this happens all the way from the sea to the mountains. You have a community, so you have everybody from the community working together to be able to exist together.
If you look at the property, it's in a little horseshoe design, and it starts off with the top of the mountains, where it's very, very wooded, lots of shade, lots of water, and it works its way down to the ocean. It gets a little bit more sparse, and then you have the beach at the end. And that's really what the basis of the design was built on, was that ahupua'a system.
There are countless stories at Aulani, and I think that's by design. In fact, when we were designing the resort, we wanted to make sure there were layers and layers of stories because this place tells the story, or parts of the stories, of the native Hawaiian culture. And really important is that we wanted our guests who came back here first time they were here, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years out, over the course of their lifetime, to come back here with fresh eyes and see these stories revealed to them. So when you walk through, say, the Maka'ala lobby, the first time you might see it, you might think it's this grand, beautiful space. The second time you walk through it, you might start to pick out little architectural details, like, oh, I thought I saw that at the Bishop Museum, or wait a second, isn't that about hula, or isn't that piece there, that carved bowl, does that have something to do with the way the Hawaiians navigated the world using stars? So essentially, for us, when we design things at Disney, we design things to be experienced over the course of a lifetime, not just in a week's day.
The design of the rooms in the villas I thought were very smart. When they designed the rooms, they really thought about who our guest is going to be, and our guests are families at the core of it. And when families come into a room or hotel, they enjoy the room. Let's just put it that way. So when you look at the room is very comfortable. It's contemporary in how it's utilized as far as the lighting structures, the doors and such. But when you look at the countertops or the armoires, they're a little distressed. So if, you know, my child, my little four-year-old comes down and puts a glass of water down on the table and we forget about it for 3 days, it's not going to cause a problem if it has a ring there because the wood's all distressed. Everything has a very soft tone to it, and it's just very, very user-friendly when it comes down to families. Now, when you look at it from a cultural standpoint, you know, the drapes here have authentic kapa, was made by a kapa artist out of Waianae. Our floors here, carpeting, has kalo, or the taro plant, on top of it. We have matting here, which is authentic matting made in ancient culture in Hawaii as well. We have kapa pounders on the sides of the mirrors. We have poi pounder lamps that comprise our lamps and our fixtures there. Our doors have these little butterfly hinges in them. It's a real unique woodcraft that the Hawaiians had way back in the past, and they're represented in our doors here as well. I mean, there's so many little things. You know, we say that when we talk about the property in general, the rooms are like, it's like an onion, and you keep peeling back piece by piece, and you learn more and more and more. Even when I come and stay at the resort like I am today, I find these little things in the room that are just unique to the room. That I haven't seen perhaps the last time and throughout the property. So, you can go on and on about all those very, very minute details that they've worked in. So every time somebody comes to the property, they're always exploring and seeing something new that is truly representative of the culture. I'll add one more. One is really unique, and you really can't appreciate it during the day. But if you see a lot of the resorts in Hawaii, you see these tiki torches, and they're like this, they're crossed, and you got flames coming out of them out of the gas. But when we looked at that, that's truly not Hawaiian. It's more Tahitian. It's more out of the 40s and 50s when resorts started to build up. It looks cool. It looks great. But we figured, well, that's not truly representative of the culture. So Joe came up with a really cool idea to have these little bowls of lava, and they put a little flame in it. And really what it represents is the kukui nut was the oil and the fuel that they used to create flame. And they used to put it in these little stone bowls, and they used to use it as flame in the evening. So throughout the property here, we have about 200 or so of these little bowls. When you look at it from the top of your room, you'll see points of light throughout the whole resort. How we duplicated it is we put it in bowls of water, and there's a little bit of a light in there that kind of looks like a very faint light, which is what it would look like in the old days if you had a little kukui nut bowl burning this little flame. And that's the small little touches that are just, I find just incredible, you know, that they could represent that in true form and stay that close to that cultural piece.
We knew that in order to be about the Hawaiian culture, if Aulani was meant to be a steward for their stories, that we needed to have Native Hawaiians collaborating with us and making sure their voices were heard. And so what we did was we went out and we talked to artists and sculptors and carvers and said, hey, you know what? We want to make sure that your art is present here. So there were dozens and dozens and dozens of Native Hawaiians who lent their talents to what you see around you is Aulani. Shockingly, we learned towards the opening of the resort that we have one of the largest collections of contemporary Native Hawaiian art in the world. We never meant to do that, but that's just what you do when you want to do the right thing. And for us, all we wanted was for the Hawaiians to have a voice. We wanted them to bring their paint, their masterpieces, onto our blank canvas. And that's what you see that is Aulani today. The great thing about the art collection for Aulani is that it's everywhere, and it's not just hung on the walls. While we have art on every elevator corridor of every level on any of our lobby levels going into the guest rooms, we have the art in the public area spaces, even out front. There's these three large carved images out front that represent Maui and Maui's three brothers, for example. Now, that may not necessarily be art to our guests, but that's art to the artists who are Hawaiian. They actually are welcoming our guests as well, and they tell story. But it's art that's every piece of the resort, right? In fact, the Hawaiian artisans actually didn't just carve things physically. They incorporated a lot of the designs into what you see as the wallpaper, into what you see as the duvet covers, into what you see as the carpet itself. So this collection of art isn't just a museum-like setting, right? In fact, Aulani isn't a museum. While we have traditional art pieces, we have art everywhere, and that's a reflection of the Hawaiians who wanted to lend their talents and their voices to the resort itself. When you walk through the Makaala lobby, you might actually hear the music if you're paying attention. Now, most people don't hear it right away because they're overwhelmed with all the details, but I promise you, you hear this powerful voice, and that voice belongs to Kealiʻi Raishel. Kealiʻi Raishel is an award-winning kumuhula, but also one of the most popular Native Hawaiian music artists of all time. And it was, in fact, very difficult to get him to agree to work for us. I love telling this story because, you know, when people think about Disney coming to Hawaii, a lot of people had reservations in the beginning because they thought that it was just going to be about our fabulous five characters. It was about Mickey and Minnie. And the truth is, while Mickey and Minnie are here, we were celebrating Hawaii, and we had to get that story out. So we met with Kealiʻi Raishel the first time, and he didn't want to talk to us. When we told him what this resort was about, he said, you know what, now I'm interested. So we worked with Kealiʻi Raishel. It was Disney and Mark Mancina, who is a Grammy Award-winning composer. Those two worked together to create what is the music of the Makaala.
This project's probably different from anything that I've done, in that the goal has been to create an atmosphere at the Aulani that's going to bring back ancient Hawaiian tradition without it being too imposing on the fact that this is a resort where people are coming to relax and enjoy themselves.
We're telling several stories. First and foremost, it's the story of the place where Aulani is, because that's, to me, that's the epicenter of the poetry. And then we expanded ourselves, kind of like when you drop a pebble in a pond and the ripples go out. And so Aulani is the epicenter. The island of Oahu is the next ripple out. And then from that point, we didn't want to leave anybody out because it's not just about Oahu. And so we expanded ourselves further from one end of the archipelago to the other to encompass all of those things that are located between the island of Hawaii, which is on one end, and the island of Niihau, which is on the other.
This music is from note one created for the Aulani Resort. It's strains of music, it's pieces, and it's pieces that flow in and out. It's ancient, it's at times somewhat tribal feeling, it's percussive, it's also very melodic, it's also very gentle, but it's very emotional. It covers a lot of boundaries, it goes to a lot of places.
The composition aspect of what I do and what other composers do is we take a snapshot of whatever emotion that we're feeling at that time, whatever we see at that time, it becomes that poetic snapshot. And what we hope is, you know, 50 years from now, 100 years from now, that our compositions will provide the future generations a window into what we saw, a window into what we felt. Because all of the old chants that came before us that go back 2,000 plus years, every single piece that I've seen so far in my life provides that snapshot, that window, into their mindset. And for me, as a composer, that is the greatest thing, because really, all we are is really vessels. Yeah. In my lifetime, I hope that I am a good vessel of the knowledge of my ancestors, so that when I'm ready to pour this out to the next generation, that their vessels become full and they're able to add and then pour to the next, and they're able to add and pour to the next.
There's always an energy in a lobby, and it can be an energy of relaxation. It can also be a frantic energy. People are arriving, coming, and waiting for something. I think what this does is it grounds the Alani Resort into the tradition of Hawaiian culture, which is so deep that it's not like background music. It's really part of the resort. It's really part of the experience of being there. So what I'm hoping for is that people that come in a frantic pace or that have been traveling, this music also brings them into a different world and brings them into a different state of mind, so that by the time they come back through that lobby, it's somewhat transformed them.
Yes, it's a resort, and yes, it's an important place. And yes, we want visitors who come from all over the world to experience who we are through all of their senses. Yet at the same time, it has to speak to us as a people, those of us who are involved intimately with this, as well as those who are from Hawaii who are going to go and visit Aulani. For us to go there and to be able to marvel at the creativity of not only our ancestors, but also of Na Mamo, you know, those who came after them and those who will come after us, that this is possible, that this is what we can do. Look, and if given the opportunity, we can express ourselves in a way that has never been done before. And I think Aulani has kind of opened the door to that kind of possibility. And that's, I'm really happy about that. It's a wonderful sense of pride, and it's a wonderful way for us to reconnect with each other, with that place, and with our ancestors.
There is magic throughout Aulani, and the magic, of course, is Hawaiian-based.
The Menehune are a race of small people, kind of diminutive little fellows, as I often like to say, and they lived here in Hawaii even before the arrival of the ancient Hawaiians. These days, they mostly keep to themselves. They generally live up in the mountains, far away from everybody, and they only come out at night as they don't like to be seen by folks like you and me. You see, the Menehune have a reputation for being very kolohe, as we say in Hawaiian. Kolohe means mischievous or rascally. They're known to wreak a little havoc from time to time, to be a little troublesome. But in addition to being kolohe, they're also very industrious. They love to build stuff. They're famous for building loko'ia, or fish ponds, awai, or irrigation ditches. And they also, well, they have an interesting law that states that any project that these menehune undertake must be completed before the sun rises, before the first rooster crows in the morning. So luckily, these guys, they work very hard. They work very well together, and all these little hands work in unison. They can make a quick job out of anything that they do. Over at the Menehune Bridge, a little water park area here in the middle of Waikolohe Valley, well, legend has it that that was created overnight by the Menehune. They saw that there was a need here for some place for the keiki to play and have some fun. And so, well, one morning, we came out here and boom, there was the Menehune Bridge ready to be played upon already. Just one night is all it takes for the Menehune to get all the work done they need to do.
Now, the Menehune are everywhere because they're magic, they're mischief. And for us, it was a fun way to convey to our keiki, or our younger guests, what the Hawaiian culture can be about for them too. And so there's a game that our guests like to play, which is Spot the Menehune.
Legend has it there are around 300 Menehune scattered all throughout the grounds at Aulani. I always say legend has it because nobody knows for sure exactly how many there are. The most that anybody's found so far that they've reported to me that I found credible was 202. She was a very meticulous 10-year-old girl. She had very fastidious bookkeeping skills, if you know what I mean. And she would update me every day on where she found them and how many she found, and that's why I believe her. That record has stood for about 6 months now, and I imagine it's going to be around for quite some time. And indeed, these little guys are all over the place. If you go over to Auntie's Beach House, you're bound to find some inside and in the playground as well. If you go over to Rainbow Reef, our aquarium here at Aulani, you might see a couple of menahune hanging out underwater with the fish. If you ride the elevators, well, you might have a special surprise in store for you. The menahune are all over the place here in Aulani, and well, you never quite know where you might find them.
For guests staying at the Aulani Resort and Spa, there's never a need to look very far for something exciting or relaxing to do.
The Waikolohe Valley is the centerpiece of Aulani, and Waikolohe means mischievous waters, and it's a perfect name for what is at the center of the resort.
There are so many things you can do here at the Waikolohe Valley. We have four different pools, starting with our Waikolohe pool, which is our main pool that has a zero-point entry that also has the constellation lights in the bottom of the pool that shine at night. We also have the Waikolohe stream, which is an experience you can have with our tubes, where you can go down the stream with your entire family in single or double tubes and enjoy the lazy river.
But this is certainly not your typical lazy river.
Within the stream itself, you have menahunes who create mischief. There are jets that pop out of crevices and rocks. You go through a misty lava tube. You might get wet in all sorts of places you weren't expecting because rain is coming from overhead.
You can drift along with your eyes closed, but if you keep them open, you may discover something fascinating.
The rock work within the whole valley is done with these incredible animal designs. Kino lau is what they call it in Hawaiian. It's representative of spirits of animals that would come to people.
In our new Kamako Landing, we have a brand new infinity-edged pool with a beautiful grotto-like cavern that hangs overhead.
We also have the Wailana pool, which is our adult only. If you prefer a more quiet area where you can enjoy some quiet time at the pool.
And for those who like their activities a bit less active, there are cabanas available for rent.
Our cabanas are for the families that want to feel like they're at home here in the Waikolohe Valley. We have a TV where you can watch your favorite game, as well as upgraded seating and refrigerators so they can store their cold items in there as well. We have a cabana host that takes care of you throughout your entire day here in the Waikolohe Valley.
And when you're ready to get off your upgraded seat, you can experience a snorkeling adventure without ever leaving the Waikolohe Valley.
Part of the Waikolohe Valley is the Rainbow Reef snorkeling experience, where you can enjoy in a safe and secure area snorkeling for your entire family. We have lifeguards that are there to attend and keep you safe, as well as an attendant that can show you how to experience and enjoy the over 1,300 fish we have in that area.
Rainbow Reef is teeming with sea life. It's like swimming in a soup of rainbow-colored fish.
For another thrill, two water slides lie ahead at the center of the valley.
One being the Tube Stone Curl. That's an experience that you can have with tubes, both double, where you could go with a friend of yours or a family member, or you can go by yourself in a single tube. And it's a really great experience. It leads you right into our Waikolohe stream.
And the second is a body slide known as Volcanic Vertical.
You would experience breathtaking turns where you might not even know where you're going, but it's probably the best experience because you scream the whole way down.
For the little ones, there's a special place that is all their own.
The Menahune Bridge, which by legend was built by the Menahune overnight. It's a perfect place for our kids to run around. There's water wheels, there's water squirting in different places, there's slides.
It is a world for truly the kids only. Kids love it there. They run up and down. They have water splashing everywhere. A canoe that tips over every once in a while that pours water everywhere, and the kids love it.
And there's even a magical spot for the tiniest of all.
Keiki Cove is our new kids feature that is located in our Komaka Grotto. It is truly the experience for our infants, where water shoots out of our octopus and it shoots all over that area. And there's little magic things that you can see in the wall as well, from our fish to our octopus, different areas that you can see and experience as a kid.
So there's water for everyone, lots of watery fun in our Waikolohe Valley.
And if you venture out of Waikolohe Valley, you're sure to find more water.
Aulani sits on a perfect crescent-shaped lagoon. It's white sands with these turquoise waters, and it's protected, right, by a reef, so our guests can go out there and swim around safely.
We have kayaking, paddle boards, snorkeling equipment. You can get out there and swim. You can experience the whole time with your family, as we have sand toys and boogie boards that are also available in our lagoon.
One of my favorite things about sitting on that lagoon is that it fronts the Pacific Ocean, and in the winters when the whales come through, you get this spectacular view of breaching whales, of whales that are just traveling through the area and playing around. And it's one of my favorite places to go, because while Aulani has so much in store for our family, I think it's really great to be able to swim in the ocean, to be able to swim with the fish that are right outside these waters here, and then also to be able to connect with nature and, at the right time of year, be able to see whales swimming by.
When you're ready to take your relaxation seriously, the Laniwai Spa awaits you.
The name Laniwai means freshwater heaven, and the meaning behind that comes from the water coming from the heavens, the rain, ua, coming to the land, giving life, and then going back up to the heaven where it came from. So the inspiration of our name Laniwai comes from that.
The 1,800 square foot spa features 15 treatment rooms, a fitness center, and a full service salon. An additional 5,000 square feet outside of the spa are dedicated to the hydrotherapy garden.
Our hydrotherapy garden is called Kulawai, and Kulawai means water source. Our guests can come an hour before their services to enjoy all that we have to offer out there.
Including 6 different rain showers, hot and cold whirlpools, herbal soaks, and a reflexology path. And while the spa offers rooms for families, the teens get a spa all their own, known as Painted Sky.
In there, our teens can enjoy services from pedicures, manicures, also massages and facials. They can also create their own body polish using the ingredients that we have here for them. It also has our Rip Swirl, which is our yogurt bar for our teens. And with every service, the teens get complimentary yogurt.
And there's also activities for teens, including classes and games.
So Laniwai is unique in a way that it's not only a spa, because the spa within itself is just a building, but it's the cast members that make it come to life and bring that magic for our guests.
As if the Waikolohe Valley and the lagoon weren't enough to keep you busy, the Aulani offers many forms of entertainment.
Auntie's Beach House is one of the most popular venues that we have here at Aulani. Children can participate in a variety of different arts and crafts, structured programming, and get a chance to meet other kids their own age while on vacation, and maybe make a few friends. Auntie is indeed there. She does storytelling and interacts with children in the space, really setting the stage for them to enjoy their vacation and talk a little bit about Hawaii and how important the culture is to the people here and to our guests.
Guests have an opportunity in turn to help Auntie on the Menahune Adventure Trail.
The Menahune Adventure Trail is sort of our interactive scavenger hunt throughout the Waikolohe Valley. It tells the story of Auntie, who is a local here, and essentially our guests help solve problems and they bring magic to life through the help of the Menahune.
The Menahune Adventure Trail is a great opportunity for guests to experience some hidden treasures at the resort through technology.
And Auntie's story guides you on your adventure.
She talks about the resort, she talks about her family, and you really become engaged in this adventure and this storytelling, and along the way are able to trigger certain effects that help enhance the story.
You see a cup of pattern come to life with sparkle and shine. You see drums that automatically go off. You see blowholes come out of whales. It's pretty dramatic and a lot of fun.
It really encourages our guests to look two and three times. Things are not always as they appear.
For us, the Menahune are the special heart of Aulani, and it really is a place for our keiki, our younger guests, to feel a little bit of that magic that is the Hawaiian culture.
But there is also Disney magic.
We also have the characters that are here on vacation. Very unique, because the characters live in Disney World, they live in Disneyland and the other parks, but here they're coming on vacation. And so our guests see them in aloha attire, they're in the pool splashing around, they're mixing and mingling with the guests.
Here at Aulani, we do have our character breakfast that allows our guests to visit with them up close and personal in a very intimate way while they're having breakfast. In addition, Auntie has a great party planned for them in the morning. She tells stories, engages guests, asks them to get up and dance with her and parade through the restaurant with our characters. It's a great way to start the day.
We really obviously value having the characters here because obviously the kids want to see them, the adults want to see them, and they're truly part of the Disney culture itself. So it's a great marriage, it's just a great blend of cultures together, the Hawaiian culture and Disney's culture.
In addition to seeing the characters in person, at the end of the day, you can also see your favorites on a giant outdoor movie screen.
Ohana movie nights happen out on the Holowai lawn, and this is a great opportunity for our families to spend time together at the end of the evening.
There's nothing quite like enjoying a Disney family movie with your Ohana under the stars, feeling the breeze of the ocean. Unless it's being riveted by a Hawaiian tale, as spun by Uncle.
Mo'olelo Fire Pit Storytelling is a great way for our guests to experience some of the stories of Hawaii that a lot of children here have grown up with in an environment that Uncle sets for them. Uncle, who is our ambassador or proverbial caretaker of the resort, brings these stories to life around the fire pit in a very intimate environment that engages the guests. It's a great way to wind down the evening.
Perhaps the ultimate way to end your evening at Aulani may be the Starlight Hui.
Starlight Hui is our main stage show and really the jewel in the crown, I think, as far as our entertainment offerings here. It's a great opportunity for our guests to experience in depth and in a very intimate way what it's like to be Ohana.
Before the show begins, guests have a unique opportunity to meet with some amazing Hawaiian artisans.
One of the offerings we have here at Aulani is our artisan program, which offers our guests an opportunity to meet, speak with, and learn some of these cultural crafts that our artisans present, often giving the history of that, the relevance today, and why that's an important piece of the Hawaiian cultural fabric. But more than that, there's a story. Our artisans talk about growing up in Hawaii and how they've developed a love or passion for the culture and help to pass that on to our guests. And that is the pre-show that sets the stage for the main show with musicians, dancers, in a really beautifully crafted production. Very emotional, highs and lows. It includes children in an interactive way. They get to get up and learn our Aulani hula and participate in the show as well. Really a feast for the eyes and ears. The Starlight Hui really focuses on Hawaiian heritage, authentically. I think a lot of guests come to Hawaii knowing more about Tahitian, Polynesian. Those are all great things to experience, but here at Aulani, we really focus on the Hawaiian aspect and try to do it right, authentically, and we've engaged a lot of cultural advisors to make sure that we are doing it that way. So we're very proud of that.
The entertainment at Aulani will surely create memories that will last a lifetime. remarkable things to see and do at Aulani. One can certainly work up an appetite. Lucky for you, Aulani has that covered. And if you seek a breathtaking location on the beach, look no further than the culinary experience of Ama'ama, named for the Hawaiian mullet prized by ancient Hawaiian royalty.
Ama'ama was designed in a way that our guests, stepping back, might actually think that they are in an old hale that's been inhabited by a family for many, many, many years.
It tells the story of Auntie and Uncle's time from the beginning till the current day. So it starts off telling the story of Auntie and Uncle way back in the day. They have their old hale. It's a traditional style thatched roof, very rustic, very wood grains, a lot of feel of very being comfortable in an old style Hawaiian home. And that's where Auntie and Uncle first laid footprints here. That is the welcoming area where you first walk into our beautiful Ama'ama restaurant. The next progression, children are away, so Auntie and Uncle began to upgrade their home. And so in the center court, you'll have a more modern feel. The decor changes from an old traditional style home to something you might see in latter day 60s, 70s. And then we come into where we're currently sitting, into the modern hale, where the family has come back to live back at home with mom and dad. So it's the addition to the house that is very modern. The decor is more sleek. The ceiling is noticeably different. But throughout the whole restaurant, you'll notice a theme of island life.
There are generations of Hawaiians who have a very rich connection to the sea, and that is all imbibed and integrated into the design of Ama'ama.
But at Ama'ama, it is the food that takes center stage.
Island-style cuisine, some fare that's very light, very fresh, lots of fish-driven dishes, very colorful, very flavorful. Lots of influences from not only Hawaii, but through the Pacific Rim. We especially like to feature fresh island products, fresh island fish, produce, and as much local ingredients as we can. On our beachfront, we also have our off-the-hook lounge. The fish hook plays an integral role not only in the restaurant or lounge, it also plays a role in the Hawaiian culture as well. We do lunch and dinner nightly. At lunchtime, we feature fresh island fish tacos, local grilled fish, grilled meats, things that you'd find around the poolside. Of course, we have hamburgers, of course we have hot dogs for the children, but also we have some cool things that are unique to Ama'ama as well as Off the Hook. The lounge itself is a beautiful open-air lounge. We do have football on Sundays. We do also like to feature live Hawaiian music nightly, and we also very much are proud of our dinner, what we call pupus in Hawaii. It's a heavy hors d'oeuvre menu, which would be great for lounging as well as conversation, gathering with others, sharing food. Of course, being a lounge in Hawaii, we have some wonderful drinks.
And if you just can't decide between all of the wonderful items to eat at Ama'ama or Off the Hook at Makahiki, you won't need to choose. You can try them all.
Our Makahiki restaurant is the bounty of the islands. And where Ama'ama is a contemporary island cuisine, the Makahiki is a more of a festival. The Makahiki is the Hawaiian word for the harvest festival. It's in a buffet setting, so you can try as little, as much as you like. From the time you walk in, you get a sense of just this warmth and this sense of really being in Hawaii.
And for breakfast, you can try the local favorite, the loco moco.
Sounds strange to a lot of people, but what it is a grilled hamburger patty with a poached egg, some steamed white rice, and brown gravy. Until you get to try one, just imagine it, and when you do see it, please don't be afraid. But what we like to do is to expose people to not only our different cuisine, but also cuisines from around the world.
For the dinner buffet, the selection is vast.
Lots of fish, a wide array of salad bars, soups, and of course sashimi and sushi nightly. And we have a beautiful Hawaiian spice salt rub crusted prime rib on our carving buffet. And then of course we have a wonderful array of local style desserts, mango cheesecake, passion fruit panna cottas, fresh fruits. It's just a great time to be had by all.
But sometimes a guest's busy schedule of lounging and spa treatments just makes it too difficult to find the time to sit down and eat. Well, Aulani thought of that too.
So we're very excited to introduce the Ulu Cafe. It's the newest restaurant on the Aulani property. And it is a quick service restaurant. It has a little something for everyone. We have lots of great fresh island fruits, yogurt parfaits. We have sandwiches ready to go, grab and go items. So you can just grab something real quick and leave. Or we can also sit down and have a meal. We do flatbreads. We have a great Kalua pork, which is a island style roasted pork, and pineapple. So rather than the traditional Hawaiian pizza, we do a Kalua pork and pineapple flatbread. Great place to grab ice cream. We also have some smoothies. We have coffee drinks. And we also have a great array of all kinds of desserts, cookies, pastries.
And if you're really torn about leaving the Waikolohe Valley, you can grab a bite right here.
Right at the base of our slides, we have this wonderful restaurant called Mama Snack Stop. And it's a great little fast place to grab a quick bite. It features a unique style of hot dog. Don't want to ruin it for you, but when you do see it, you'll be pleasantly surprised. It's a wonderful little stop just to grab a quick bite.
Right next to Mama's, you can enjoy an all-time Hawaiian favorite, shave ice.
For those who haven't been to Hawaii, the shave ice is what we would have instead of a snow cone. It's something that is Japanese in origin, but we've taken it to heart here in Hawaii, and what we get is this wonderful mound of just shaved, snow-like fluffy ice. And we season it with all kinds of great local flavors, mango, lihimui, passion fruit, coconut, limes, lemons, all these great sort of flavors that you would only be able to combine in Hawaii.
But what if you're at the lagoon and it's just too far to walk to Mama's?
If you don't want to leave because you came to Hawaii just to go to the beach, we've taken care of that for you as well. We have a spot called Little Opihi. It's located right here on our beach in front of the Aulani.
Okay, we've had our fill of food, and now it's time for a drink. But where to go?
Alelo Room is a lot of fun. In fact, Alelo is all about the language of the Hawaiian culture. Alelo means word, and the Alelo Room is a reflection of words from the Hawaiian language. In fact, there are words all over the place. Everything is labeled in Hawaiian, from our cast members' costumes, so you'll see a mu'umu'u down the side of a dress. You might see the name of shirt on one of the bartender's shirts. You'll see the name of the floor, or what the Hawaiian word is for floor, on the floor itself.
Even the chair itself has the Hawaiian name, nohe, what it is for chair. The tables all have the names on them, the door.
And then in hundreds of shadow boxes that are hung throughout the space, you'll see carved wood figures that have their associated Hawaiian word with them.
And the entire staff cast of the Olelo Room all are native Hawaiian speakers. So they will converse with you in Hawaiian, they will talk to you, introduce themselves as well as their culture, speak to you, answer questions, just try to give you even a language lesson for the amount of time that you're there with them.
Our guests can enjoy a drink or a meal and at the same time learn about the Hawaiian language. Yes, it might be difficult to say huma huma nuka nuka apua'a, but hopefully by the end of our guest day they can say it without tripping up, B, understand that it's the state fish of Hawaii, and C, be able to look at the carvings in the room and say, oh, I'm starting to make associations.
It's not all learning. You can also have some wonderful food, great cuisine, as well as some amazing drinks. We also feature nightly entertainment, and you can get contemporary island music as well as traditional Hawaiian music. The ukulele is played often. Our cast members often break into dance and the hula if the mood is right. Everything about the Olelo Lounge is pure, authentic Hawaiian. And it's just beautiful just to hear the language spoken. It's just an amazing, amazing sense to immerse yourself in the Hawaiian language. So here at Aulani, from the old saying, from soup to nuts, or from poi to macadamia nuts, what we try to do here is give something for everyone, just a little taste of the islands on your vacation here with us. Not only leave you with great memories of the islands and great memories of the resort, but also the food you had here. And as we say at Aulani, ikomo mai, welcome home. We hope to welcome you back and share with you as much as we can through our cuisine.
we designed Aulani, we wanted to make sure that it was informed by the past. So when you walk through the resort, you can see the traditional elements. Guests recognize these things as traditional, or at least inspired by what is traditional. But at the same time, it has a very contemporary feel, and that's on purpose. So we're inspired by the past in this present moment, looking to the future. And what we mean by looking to the future in this contemporary feel is it's reflected in the contemporary Hawaiian art that's all around us. It's contemporary in the sense that if you look at some of the designs of our spa, Laniwai Spa, or you look at Ama'ama, some of the interior finishes are very contemporary, and that's on purpose. We want our guests to remember that the native Hawaiian culture is not dead. While it is very rich in tradition and it has a long history and a long past, it is alive today and it is looking to the future, and the Hawaiians are very much present, and they're taking the future and they're holding on to it. And I think Aulani does a very good job of reflecting that spirit. Aulani is a beautiful, majestic, amazing place. There are so many stories here. There are so many stories about the native Hawaiian culture. And I think when our guests spend time here, they spend their vacation here, they have lots of memories. But I think what we hope for them is that when they leave here, they start to ask questions. What does that mean? And how does that connect to, say, hula? Or how does that connect to architecture? How does that connect to what's important about the culture? I think if we have done our job correctly as Walt Disney Imagineers, we will not only have given our guests an amazing vacation, we'll have given them more. We'll have given them the opportunity to open their eyes, open their mind to the possibilities of what the Hawaiian culture is really about. And so when they start asking questions like, oh, we had a fun time doing hula, but what does hula really mean? So maybe they'll do their own research, but the next time they come back here, because we know and we hope that they'll come back, that they'll come with them this sort of richness of understanding, with their minds open and wanting to experience more. And what I mean by more is not just have a vacation, but to explore what Hawaii is really about. So when they leave Aulani and say go to the rest of Oahu, and they go into Honolulu, maybe they go to the Bishop Museum, maybe they take our excursions up to the North Shore, they start to make connections. And when you make connections, a vacation isn't a vacation anymore. It becomes a life experience. It becomes something more meaningful. It becomes something more rich. It becomes something more deep. And then that's where you feel magic, right? And when our guests feel magic, and I don't mean Disney magic, because that Disney magic is there, but I mean magic in the everyday, magic in experiencing what you want with your family on vacation, that's the sort of thing that you remember for the rest of your life. And if we can inspire our guests to feel that way about the Hawaiian culture, to feel this way about Aulani and the space that we sit here in Oahu, then we've done our job. And we've done it well, and that's my hope.
Disney coming into this resort and opening the resort made a commitment to the culture and to the community. That really raised the bar. I've been in the industry for 20, 25 years here, and a lot of resorts have tried to emulate or perpetuate the culture here, really talk to the culture, because that's truly what people come to Hawaii for, is to take in the culture, take in that Hawaiian hospitality. That's different than any place in the world. That's truly what holds our brand together as Hawaii. And I think Disney has risen the bar. When I talk to my colleagues throughout the industry here, we truly have opened their eyes to this is truly what we should be doing. This perpetuates our service culture here in Hawaii, and it's really what every resort should be doing. And so I'm really proud to be part of that and part of a little bit of a renaissance of bringing the culture back into tourism here in Hawaii. As a phenomenal job that Disney has done in building this fantastic resort. We have such a great set of amenities, great entertainment program. Our rooms, I think, are fantastic. The value that you get from a customer staying here is fantastic. But I think at the end of the day, the best asset that we have truly are our people. Time and time again, the comment cards we get back, the letters that we get, the emails that we get, all talk, number one, to what sincere, genuine Hawaiian hospitality that they're getting every time they come to stay at Aulani. And that just, you know, it makes me emotional to a standpoint, because it's very difficult to get that here in Hawaii. And I think the people that we have here, they're just fantastic. You know, they truly want to share a little bit about themselves with our guests, and that's what makes it different. That relationship that they create when they talk to them, when they share about the stories of Aulani, creates that memorable experience that you can't get any other place except for here. And it's truly a little bit of that Disney touch of, you know, the culture, the service culture that we have mixed in with that Hawaiian hospitality that is just, it's just fantastic. You just can't get anywhere else.
And so remember, when you are called to Hawaii, Aulani will be waiting.